Welcome to Office 2013, video project number 17.5. Hey, last video we saw how to create a PowerPoint presentation from a Word document. So in this video, we just want to see some basic formatting of a PowerPoint presentation. And then in our next project, 18, we'll see a bunch of cool PowerPoint tricks. So here's the file we created last video, PowerPoint class notes. Double click and open it up. Hey, there's our PowerPoint presentation, totally blank. Now we're just going to do a couple basic things here. And the first one is quite dramatic if you've never seen how to use PowerPoint, because PowerPoint looks fancy, but it's really easy to create a beautiful PowerPoint presentation. I'm going to go to the Design Ribbon tab. And there's a bunch of themes. Now watch this. You hover, and it will give you a little screen tip that says what it is and a preview. I'm going to go ahead, and there's a More button. Boop, and there's a bunch more you can get to. Escape, I'm going to select that one right there. It says Ion, but watch what happens. A single click. Notice only slide number one is selected, but a single click, boop, and instantly, boop, they all get the formatting. Now, you can come over to Variants, and this is new in 2013. They have the themes and then the variants. I'm going to select on blue. So quickly formatting your whole PowerPoint presentation is easy. Now, that's just the design using a theme. Let's go over to transitions. We'll talk about animations next video, but transitions, that's the movement between slides. So if I select random bars, notice it gives me a preview. Click the More button, comb. Click the More button. This is a presentation about boomerangs, of course, and they used to have a built-in one that came with PowerPoint called Boomerang, but it's not here anymore. Let's try Fracture. Look at this one. It falls away. That'd be a great, I guess, if your boomerang goes and hits a window or something. Slide number one selected. And right there is a star. That means it has either animation or transitions, but none of the other slides have that star. So you got to remember to click Apply to All in the timing group. Boop. And instantly we see we have all of our stars. Now we want to do two things to our slides before we see how to start the presentation. I'm going to click on the slide, and in the Home ribbon, we have a choice of Layout. So in the Slides group, Layout, I'm going to select Title Slide. And instantly, it changes the layout. That's much nicer for our title slide. Now I'm going to use my scroll bar here. You can see we have 9 slides. I'm going to select number 7. Go back up to Layout, and I would like to have a bullet on one side and a picture on the other. Now there's title, and content. That's the default. Section, to content, even comparison, and there's a few others here. We'll use a few others in the next video. I'm going to select to content. Just like that, it keeps our title. There's what's called a placeholder. There's a placeholder here, and here we want to click on this placeholder and insert a picture. This slide is about keeping your boomerang vertical. You gotta, if you're throwing a boomerang, you gotta throw it vertical, not flat like a frisbee. So I'm gonna go see if there's a picture online. I'm gonna click online. And in Bing, I'm gonna type throw boomerang vertical. Enter. Show all web results. And look at that, there's a bunch of pictures. I'm going to click on this one right here. Nice picture of throwing a boomerang vertical. Click Insert. And just like that, we've inserted a picture. Now, the nice thing about inserting the picture directly into the placeholder is that later when we do animations and next videos, you'll see that the placeholders will receive that automatic animation. All right, I'm going to click on the corner. And when I see my diagonally pointing two-way arrow, I'm going to click and drag. Let me click and drag over here, too. All right, now we want to F12 to save as. I don't want to replace this second file. I'm going to hit F12. And I'm going to change the name just the very end. Instead of second, like we named it in last video, I'm going to call it done. So boomerangs are easy to throw, done. And click Save. Now, we could go to start it, to slideshow. From the beginning is F5. From the current slide is Shift F5. All right, I'm going to hit F5. And how do you move forward? You can hit Enter. You can hit the space bar. You can hit the down arrow. The nice thing about the arrow keys is notice here it's go to a large park, stand in the middle. But somebody says, I want to go back, use the up arrow. We go back to the previous slide, up arrow. Man, I wish I had the up arrow when I was throwing boomerangs and broke that window. That's really cool. It like the window comes back together. So the arrow keys are nice because you can go forwards and backwards. And so there we go. Now, how do we stop the presentation? Escape. All right, so that's just a little bit about basic PowerPoint formatting and playing your show. In our next video, we'll create a PowerPoint from scratch in PowerPoint and learn a bunch of cool tricks. Like instead of the slide pane, we'll see the outline pane, and we'll even see how to insert a video and do animation. All right, we'll see you next video.